This is The Rumor Report with Angela Yee on The Breakfast Club.
Yes, Beyonce is planning to donate $100,000 to four different historically black colleges. So that's exciting, right? Mm-hmm. And her mom is discussing the conversation that they had before Beyonce's performance at Coachella. Now, she said, "I told Beyonce I was afraid that the predominantly white audience at Coachella would be confused by all of the black culture and black college culture because it was something they might not get." She captioned the photo. She said, "Her brave response to me made me feel a bit selfish and ashamed." She said, "At this point in my life and my career, I have a responsibility to do what's best for the world and not what is most popular."
Yeah, I respect Beyonce for not trading her authenticity for approval.
Now, her mom said that Beyonce also went on to say, she said that her hope is that after the show, young people would research this culture and see how cool it is. And young people, black and white, would listen to Lift Every Voice and Sing and see how amazing the words are for us all and bridge the gap.
And salute to Beyonce for donating, $400,000 to HBCU?
$100,000 to each HBCU.
$25,000 to each one.
$25,000? Mm-hmm. Salute to her. That's big. I mean, last person I think I seen do something that big was Bill Cosby. Bill Cosby donated $20 million to Spelman College once.
All right, Adrian Broner and Tekashi 6ix9ine had a back and forth on social media. Now, I didn't know the two of them, for whatever reason, didn't get along.
I thought this was over Charlamagne.
How is this over me? Listen,
Adrian Broner
is being next to a lot of people I don't want my name next to nowadays.
Broner posted a picture with Charlamagne and said, "Get that look off your face. It's fight week."
Salute to my guy, AB. He does fight this Saturday, Showtime Boxing.
So Tekashi 6ix9ine got mad and posted clown. I thought he was talking about Charlamagne being clown. That's what I thought.
He probably was.
Yeah, that's what I thought too. But then it turned into something else. And here is what Adrian Broner had to say on Instagram.
"Hey, 6ix9ine, don't be commenting no on my pictures, boy. Talking about clown. The only thing got a red nose where I'm from is a pit bull, bitch ass. And I get to New York this week. My pull up on you. I ain't one of these rap you be trolling with. Quit playing with me."
Jesus Christ.
Wow.
So, yeah, I don't know where this goes from here now.
You didn't see Tekashi's reply?
AB, I want you to be focused, my brother. Forget that all Tekashi 6ix9ine BS, okay? You got to fight this Saturday, all right?
Now, we have Tekashi's reply.
"Yo, bro, I got 100K Saturday. You lose the fight. 100K, man.
Matter of fact, bet that 200. Make it 200,
blood. Make 200K?
Make it 200, blood.
New York, blood.
New money, man.
It's my city, Earth. King New York,
blood. What you talking about, blood?
You know what I'm saying?
Huh? We got enough money.
Clown, and you better check in when you come to Brooklyn, nigga."
See that? He bet $300,000 Adrian Broner would lose.
Okay.
I think that Adrian Broner should really take him up on that bet. Because I don't think that Tekashi 6ix9ine got $300,000.
Oh, I think he has $300,000.
Yeah,
absolutely. $300,000.
But I definitely.
Is he independent?
He is independent.
I definitely think he should take him up on that bet. Absolutely 100%.
All right. Now, Meek Mill, a lot of people thought he was going to get out of jail yesterday, but it hasn't happened. The DA was trying to get him out, and the judge shut it down. Once again, Judge Denise Brinkley is not trying to make it happen. Now, they were asking for the judge to toss the 2008 conviction because prosecutors back then were fully aware that the arresting officer, Reginald Graham, was dirty, but sat on that information. So if that conviction was tossed, that would mean that Meek's probation violation would go out the window. However, the judge did not sign off on that and instead scheduled a hearing on that matter. That hearing is not until June. So now Meek is going to be in prison until June, until that hearing happens. So, yeah.
Okay.
That's unfortunate because everybody was saying he's getting out. So I don't know what's going to happen now. But like you said, a lot of people think that he shouldn't even be sitting in jail. They've proven that the arresting officer was dirty, but somehow, some way, he's still suffering the consequences of that.
That's crazy.
And I just don't understand how everybody can claim to see Meek and think that Meek has been done unjust. But nobody's stepping in to really do something. Like all of these governors and like you're the governor.
I think they're trying to. I don't think they can overturn the judge that easy.
Has anybody looked this up? We talk about this every day, but has anybody looked up if the governor can truly indeed pardon Meek? No, we haven't. Somebody needs to do some fact checking.
No, what they are saying is that the case would have to go to the Supreme Court there, and that's how they
but
have
could,
to decide
I wanna,
that.
I want to know, could the governor of Pennsylvania pardon Meek Mill? If there's anybody out there that knows, please let me know.
The governor would know, or maybe Meek's lawyer would know.
Right.
Because I'm sure they would have tried that. All right. Mariah Carey, her former manager, is suing her. In addition to money that she says that she's owed, she also is suing her because she's saying that she was naked in front of her all the time. And that was an issue. I guess she said that is sexual harassment. Now, Mariah is saying that allegation is baseless. What she's saying is that Mariah rarely wore any clothes around her and did sexual things in her presence also. Sounds like they're having some issues because she feels a little bit mad about getting fired as a manager. And she also feels like she's owed money. So now she's saying naked around her. And I will say this, women, a lot of times we are naked around each other, like just getting dressed and getting ready for things. So I don't know. Anyway, I'm Angela Yee, and that is your Rumor Report.
The Breakfast Club, every weekday morning. Tune in.